If you know the enemy and know yourself, you need not fear the result of 100 battles.
Hello everyone, my name is BM Fox. In this video, I will analyze the Allies Doctrine. So let's jump into it with the wiki. If I go to the wiki under the tab Warfare, you have the Doctrine's explanation. Here you can find all information about the four doctrines. So if you look in the column of Allies, you can see that they are all about optimization. Units need 30% less production time, so you can produce them faster. Research costs 25% less and is 25% faster, meaning that you can not only research cheaper but also faster, which means you have access to your units to produce them faster and you have access to their upgrades faster. On top of it, your upgrade costs for your units is 25% less, and they also take 20% less time to be upgraded. Very fast, you can develop a high level army. So in Allies, you're probably gonna have smaller armies, but they will be very efficient, very effective. Of course, you also have a penalty, which is for Allies, the movement speed minus 10%. Personally, I find this a real bummer because it slows down your gameplay, especially if I compare this with the Pan-Asian, which gets a 25% speed bonus. This makes a difference between the two doctrines of 30%. This is a lot. Not only do the Pan-Asian get their movement speed, but they get extra view range, they have extra terrain bonuses on top of their terrain bonuses. And so this makes Pan-Asian is really the nemesis of Allies. And Allies are gonna have a hard time and will find a challenge in fighting the Pan-Asian Doctrine. When Allies fight the Comintern Doctrine, you will notice that they are pretty much balanced. The Comintern units produced 50% cheaper, they have 30% less upkeep cost, so the Comintern Doctrine can produce more units, but they deal 10% damage. They are more or less balanced together with Allies. Now for Allies versus Axis battles, Axis gets 10% more hit points, which means that they get a bit more health, they are a bit more difficult to get killed, and they deal 15% more damage. But their units, they are more expensive. So if we come in regard of equal resources, the two, they are balanced. And not forget, it's difficult for Axis to upgrade their units because they're also more expensive, where Allies can upgrade them more cheaply. So if you're playing Allies Doctrine and you meet Axis or Comintern in the battlefield, you're gonna be pretty much fine. But if you meet Pan-Asian, fasten your seatbelts, make sure you're active because you're gonna be challenged. Now let's check the Allies bonuses for each unit branch. We're gonna start with the infantry. Motorized infantry gets a penalty where they get their upgrades, research upgrades, 1 to 2 days later than other doctrines. But their commandos, they deal 15% more damage versus unarmored units. They move 15% faster, which is actually only 5%, as they have a 10% nerf. And then we have the research, which is available 2 days sooner. So all in all, this is a very interesting unit because commandos, not only are they stealth, they get additional terrain bonuses, especially in mountains, and they ignore fortifications. So if you have an enemy that makes forts and you play with ally, you can just wreck those with commandos. Also, paratroopers get extra 10% hit points, cost 15% less. In the recent update, their deployment time has been reduced, which makes them more interesting. But up till now, I haven't really used paratroopers. Personally, I find they are more or less a niche unit. So if we check their infantry, they're not amazing. No militia, no infantry bonuses, no mechanized bonus, motorized. And like paratroopers, commandos, they're like elite units. You only use them in certain situations. So infantry is not great. If you check ordnance, anti-tank upgrades, 1 or 2 day penalty. SP artillery is a very good unit in the hands of allies player. They deal 15% extra damage versus heavy armored units. They get 15% hit points. Their research and upgrades are available sooner. So if you play allies, please use SP artillery. It's one of their best units. If we check the tank branch, light tank upgrades, they're available later. Same for medium tanks, heavy tanks, no bonus. I mean, don't use tanks with allies, because no matter which branch you encounter, you're gonna lose. They're not interesting. But to protect yourself against tanks, luckily we have the tank destroyer, which is for allies doctrine, extreme interesting, as they get at 15% move speed bonus, which nullifies their minus 10% nerf, and they also have an additional 15% reduction cost, and their research is available sooner, like with the commandos. So you can already see where I'm getting. I'm already imagining for the allies doctrine a stack of tank destroyers, SP artillery, and commandos. If we go to the air branch, the upgrades for interceptors are available sooner. Their tactical bombers are really, really good. They do extra damage versus light armored units. Their attack range is increased with 15%, and their research is unlocked sooner, which helps because bombers and also airplanes, they are less affected by the movement speed nerf that Allied Doctrine has. Also, the strategic bomber, he gets a 15% bigger range and he has 10% more hit points. Now, strategic bomber, really interesting, especially after the new update. The range has been increased, so this unit is like perfect. Go way behind the enemy lines, take out those enemy air bases, take out those production buildings, take out those bunkers. You can really hamper the air force of your enemy, their economy, their military production. Strategic bombers is a must-have for any allies player. If we go to their navy, their destroyer gets a 15% bonus versus submarines. They move 15% faster, which also nullifies again their speed reduction. Their research is unlocked faster, and this is perfect to protect them against the overpowered submarines from Axis, which is great. The rest of their navy, it doesn't get bonuses, except aircraft carrier is unlocked sooner, which is good if you want to prepare a naval invasion. You can take your planes with you, which you will have because allies, they need planes. So all in all, also the navy, it's not that interesting. I mean, you need navy as any doctrine, but it's very mediocre. I wouldn't go in a battle with any navy of the other doctrines. And if you go into battle, make sure you have the numerical advantage. Secret branch, no bonuses at all. Secret branch for allies pretty much sucks. The only interesting part for allies is that their nuclear technology is unlocked faster. The nuclear bomber has 15% more range, more hit points, but nuclear bombers are shot down very easily by anti-air and also by interceptors. So in many cases, your bomber doesn't even reach the target. The only foolproof nuclear unit is the atomic rockets, which gets a bonus. You can unlock the atomic bomb, which you need for the nuclear units. You get it sooner, but I haven't seen a lot of matches where nuclear units are really being used, especially as they only get unlocked at day 20, so day 18 for allies. Many small maps end before day 18, and the investment is just so expensive that you need to neglect other research, meaning that if you go for nuclear technology, your other unit branches are going to be less developed, less researched, less upgraded. But of course, for allies, it is easier to go nuclear if you want, but personally, I don't use it. Now, let's go in the game so I can make it a little bit more concrete for you. I'm in battle here with a Maklik, which is, you can guess, the Pan-Asian Doctrine. And I can tell you, I am really getting hammered out here. I'm trying my best, but whatever I do, he's just too fast for me. I can fly in my interceptors, but he's just gonna move out. He's 30% faster. I'm gonna patrol my interceptors. What is going to happen now? He's gonna attack me with his interceptors. Don't forget, the Pan-Asian interceptors, they get the extra damage bonus. They are faster, they have an increased range. So I've lost a lot of interceptors against Maklik, lost 14 today, and I don't have the habit of losing a lot of units, but if it goes air versus air units, it's just really challenging. Also, my armored cars are getting picked off easily by his faster air units. So I've made, like I said, I've made stacks here, armored cars, which are scout units, so that I can see the stealth units, because here in Jinshan there was an anti-tank unit. If I wouldn't have had my scout, I would have marched right into it. I've got 5 commandos, I've got 14 spear artillery, but I've split them up that I can have maximum damage output. As you know, only 10 units fight in a stack. I've got 6 tank destroyers, so whenever I get attacked, my commandos are gonna protect me against unarmored units. My tank destroyers are gonna protect me against armed units. I've got anti-air in here for allies. This is like a very good stack. No matter in which terrain I am, I'm always gonna have a terrain bonus. Whenever I want to shoot, I'm just gonna split up these babies. I've also got another stack here, which is bombarding at the moment in Mandal Uvo. This is like an early game stack, which I often use with my beginner's unit. They keep serving me throughout the game. They're well protected against anti-air. I've got anti-tank units in there. I've got infantry units in here. So no matter which kind of unit branch that attacks me, I'm gonna be fine. Allies Doctrine, perfect strategy is just going in there with these beautiful babies, armored cars. They're one of the fastest units. They can pave the way so that your artillery or bigger stacks can move faster without the enemy terrain speed, which is only 50%, so they move faster. And then you assist them with planes, so any small resistance you can take it out with your planes. So this is a very good common strategy for allies. But as you can see here, for the battle with Maklik Pan-Asian Doctrine, it's very difficult because I don't have the air superiority here. So my tactic of sending my armored cars ahead is failing because I'm getting attacked easily by his air force. I am too slow to react to his bombers. Yeah, it's difficult playing allies against Pan-Asian. I hope you got the bigger point of the doctrine. If we talk about Navy, you can see I've made a large stack. I've got 10 battleships, which are perfect against other ships. I've got 10 cruisers, which are a perfect air cover. I've got 8 destroyers against submarines. So here I am pretty much fine. I made a large stack because the Navy of allies is only mediocre. So this way I can be sure that at least I'm not gonna be on the back foot. So this is it for allies. Please try the doctrine out, even though I'm not really a fan, honestly. I'm pretty frustrated with the 10% speed penalty. I have the impression that my gameplay is way slower and everything takes like forever, but the doctrine definitely has its strengths in the mid game and then the late game. The longer the game lasts, the more overpowered this doctrine gets. You have more resources, you can research more, you can produce more, and in the end game, you can really give a good battle even against Pan-Asian if you put that in there, the activity and the gaming time. So this is it for this video. Please like and subscribe, and we're gonna see each other for another video soon.